Aimee Starstone from Mother and Baby, and today we're going to talk to you all about self-care and the importance of self-care. I'm joined by the lovely Aimee Horton, who is a mum of two and author. But first, I want to talk to you the difference between self-maintenance and self-care. Aimee, can you explain?
Definitely. I think over recent years, self-care has been commercialised as a bit of a luxury and a bit of a treat. And they're talking about self-care being brushing your teeth, having a shower, going and having a coffee or having your lunch. That's not self-care. That is self-maintenance. That's essential day-to-day life. It's not a treat. As parents, it's so easy to put everyone first. That's what we are naturally programmed to do. And when it comes to yourself, you drop down the list, whereas we all know that running on empty is not a good thing. It's not good for anybody, whether it's ourselves or our family. So even if it's just 10 minutes out of your day to find something that makes you feel rejuvenated and feel good, it'll make everything seem so much less daunting.
So as busy parents, we're both parents, we know that it's very difficult to find that time. So we have come up with 10 really easy tips to follow to just be able to carve out that 10 minutes of self-care time in your daily life.
Write a list. I know it sounds so simple and probably a little bit silly, but for me, it's a surefire way of me getting a bit of time to myself. So every morning when I sit down and write my to-do list, I schedule in 10 minutes to 40 minutes, whatever time I've got that day, just for me. Whether it's doing some yoga or curling up on the sofa with a blanket and a cup of tea, it's on my list to do, it's there to be ticked off, and it's not easily forgotten when life gets in the way.
One of my favourite self-care tips is to take a 10-minute walk just outside. It's really great for boosting energy if you're feeling a little bit sluggish, or if you're just feeling a little bit low. To get out in the fresh air can make you feel so much better.
Talk, rant, write, cry. That's what I always say. It's so important to get your emotions out in a way that you feel comfortable with. Some people might feel great about just going for a walk with a friend and putting the world to rights. Sometimes you might just want to call your mum and have a good old cry. And sometimes you might not want to, or you can't talk to anyone. So find a method such as blogging or journaling that makes you feel better. One of the best tips I've had, it's quick, it's easy. Do it before your phone time in the morning, which I know we all do straight away. And it's one thing that you're letting go. So let go that you shouted at the kids yesterday. One thing that you're grateful for, the sun shining. And one thing you're gonna focus on, having a really good breakfast. But whatever it is, think about it and get it out there.
One of the best tips I can give you for self-care is to turn off social media for a couple of hours a day, or set a restriction for the amount of time that you go on. The reason I say this is because comparison culture is really real. Scrolling through other people's lives on the internet can often make you feel a bit inadequate, or you don't feel you're as good as other people, or maybe that they've got nicer kitchens than you. So one thing I'd say is follow accounts that really inspire you or that make you feel happy, and kind of unfollow the accounts that make you feel bad about yourself. This is a really important self-care tip. So when you're not wasting all that time on social media, you can do something else instead.
We've called this one super self-care, and it's such a silly one, but it's just do something that makes you feel good. Whether you've got a favourite lipstick that when you put it on you feel like you stand taller, or you have nice nails. I like to do my nails because then whenever everything else seems to have gone to pot, at least I can write with nice nails on my keyboard. It doesn't need to be dressing for anyone, it doesn't need to be fancy, it could be as simple as your favourite comfiest slippers or even having a cup of tea out of your favourite mug.
Sleep is incredibly important to us, not just physically but mentally too. You'll know if you're an exhausted parent the effect that having no sleep can have on you. Now, sleep is something we're all entitled to. It's self-maintenance, it's not self-care, but self-care super tip is to give yourself an early night once or twice a week, especially if you've got little ones that were keeping you up in the night. You will feel so much better. Now, when you do go up to bed, switch this off before you go, at least half an hour before you go to bed. No laptops, no TVs in the room, and just getting to bed nice and early, and pick up a book. Reading a book before you fall fall asleep has the same effect on your brain as meditation.
Move your body. I'm a great believer of looking at it as moving your body and not exercise. Exercise wrongly is still associated with making you look a certain way, and that's not what this is about. This is about releasing endorphins and making yourself feel better. So whether you've got the energy to do a quick hit in the kitchen or go in the garden with the kids and run around, or you're just so tired that you just want to lie down and do some stretching and breathing, you'll be amazed how much better you feel after even just 10 minutes. I can guarantee your shoulders will feel more relaxed, your head will be clearer, and you'll be ready to carry on and face the day.
One of my favourite self-care tips is to get in the kitchen, put on some favourite songs, and get dancing. Dancing is great for the soul, isn't it? It just lifts your mood. If you're feeling tired, it can give you that real energy boost, and it's just 10 minutes out of your day to just kind of take for yourself, let go, and feel better.
Be self-aware. Easier said than done, but if you can start to understand and get the feelings of when your workload is too heavy, your children are too noisy, or everything just seems too much, then you take yourself away. Whether it's going and standing in the garden and breathing in the fresh air, or picking another self-care tip that we've given, or even if it is just going and locking the toilet door and having a wee in peace, I can guarantee that taking yourself away from the situation will work wonders.
One of my favourite self-care moments is to just take 10 minutes doing absolutely nothing. As parents, we always feel guilty about doing this, but please don't. It's so important to just recharge, even if you can only find 10 minutes in the day. One of my favourite things is to find somewhere quiet. It could just be the bedroom, sitting on the bed, or a space in the house where you know you won't be interrupted for 10 minutes. And if you can find a window with the sunlight shining on you, even better. This is my favourite hangout. Gets very rarely interrupted in here. And I just sit for 10 minutes, just sit quietly in the sunlight, just breathing. If you're into meditation, even better. If not, just sitting quietly, gathering your thoughts for 10 minutes is brilliant.
We really hope these 10 really easy to follow tips have helped you not only understand the importance of self-maintenance, but to help you carve that time out as a busy parent. I know as a parent myself, it's really, really difficult to find the time, but I make that time and I do instantly feel better. One of my favourites is the kitchen dancing. I just love, as you can see in the video, having a good dance, whether it's with my family or on my own. And it just kind of uplifts me, just that 10 minutes, taking time to have a good time. It really helps me. What about you, Aimee?
Oh, I think it's important now to point out that I learned that to make self-care a daily habit is not just to settle on one thing. It's important to be aware of your body and your mind. And so if I've got a bit of pent up stress or energy, going for a run or lifting a kettlebell or doing some yoga probably is the best thing for me. But on those days where I'm absolutely drained and even the thought of putting one foot in front of the other seems like too much, that's when I think, right, I'm going to go outside in the garden with a cup of tea and just breathe in the air and the silence, because I don't know about you, Fee, but silence to me is just such a treat as a parent.
It really is. And I think all parents will relate to that. And I think that's a nice note to end on, to just don't feel guilty about taking that time for yourself. I really hope that these tips have helped you to understand the difference between self-care and self-maintenance, and to take that time for you without feeling guilty.